The BJP's 8 short of the magic number that will give Karnataka a stable government, but that hasn't stopped Yediyurappa from staking claim to power, and he's all set to take oath as the chief minister at 9 a.m. The Congress was up in arms against the governor's decision and rushed to the Supreme Court late last night. Both the JDS and Congress filed petitions in the top court, leading to high midnight drama. The bench started hearing their petitions at 2 a.m. Aur filhal hamare saath hamare reporters jud rahe hain Deepak, Shabbir and Kajal. Let me first go across to Shabbir, in another one hour, at around 9 a.m., Yediyurappa is going to be taking the oath, swearing in as the Chief Minister of Karnataka. Tell us what is happening outside his residence, because I'm sure well-wishers must have started reaching there, congratulating him on this big day.
Well, that's right. People have started gathering here. Senior leaders of the BJP, including Jagdish Shetter, is here at BS Yediyurappa's residence. They are congratulating him. They are wishing him on this big day. But also, the question is that whether he will be able to prove the majority
right.
on the floor of the House.
Today, because we're joined by Dr. Subramanian Swamy on the phone line. Good morning to you, sir. Massive developments as far as Karnataka is concerned. Marathon hearing where the Supreme Court has at the moment decided that it will not stay the oath-taking ceremony. It will happen, but yes, a lot will depend on the letter that Yediyurappa wrote to the governor.
All these are your interpretations. The Supreme Court doesn't stay the hearing now. It can never stay it again because Yediyurappa will become chief minister. You mean that they will strike down swearing in ceremony altogether is unconstitutional. That's most unlikely. Unless Yediyurappa loses the vote on the floor, there's no way Yediyurappa can now be removed. So the Congress has had a comprehensive defeat, but the Supreme Court has sugarcoated them for it, and then the media has interpreted so much that it's not been nothing of the kind the Supreme Court has said. Neither the Supreme Court has asked for any numbers submitted by Yediyurappa, because no numbers were asked by the governor. The governor only invited him to form government.
All right,
this is the end of the stage one, that is Yediyurappa being chief minister. Then now the question is whether on the floor he wins or loses, that's all.
All right, Dr. Swamy, many thanks for joining us with those views. So, Dr. Swamy, they're saying that Yediyurappa will continue for the whole term ke liye, as the chief minister, and there is no threat as far as he is concerned.